Hey there, this is René for GNS 3Volt, and in this lab I'm going to show you the spanning tree BPDU guard lab. So what do we have? I got two devices, a switch and a router. And if you configure BPDU guard on an interface, the interface will go into error disabled mode as soon as you receive a BPDU. So what I'm going to do is configure a bridge group on router Neo. This will enable spanning tree and it will start sending BPDUs. And as soon as I receive a BPDU on the switch, I will block the interface. And besides blocking the interface, it should try to auto-recover itself again after 400 seconds. So that's what we are going to do here. And let's start with the configuration of router Neo. So what I need to do is create a bridge group. First of all, I need to enable bridging. Bridge IRB stands for integrated routing and bridging. So the router can do bridging and routing at the same time. I need to create a bridge group. And by specifying protocol IEEE, I will enable spanning tree. Go to the interface. And here I need to apply the bridge group command. And you can now see if I do show spanning tree that the router is running spanning tree. It's running spanning tree on the fast Ethernet interface. Alright, so far so good. Now on the switch, I want to make sure that whenever I receive a BPDU from the router, that it will go into error disabled mode. And I can do this with the BPDU guard command. But before I do so, I'm going to configure the automatic recovery. And let me show you an overview here. Show error disabled recovery. You can see that by default, once BPDU guard blocks an interface, it will stay disabled, so it will not auto recover automatically. So that's something I need to change. So I can type error disable recovery cause BPDU guard. Now you can see it can recover automatically, and it will take 300 seconds to do so. And one of the tasks was that I need to change the timer. So error disable recovery interval 400. And you can now see it will recover in 400 seconds. Okay, so let's enable BPDU guard so we get a an error. So interface fast Ethernet 1. And what I'll do is say spanning tree BPDU guard enable. Boom, and now you can see the interface is going down. So receive BPDU on this interface with the BPDU guard enabled. It's going into error disabled mode and the interface is now down. So if I do a show error disable recovery, you can see the interface over here. Fast Ethernet port 1, recent BPDU guard. And we have to wait for 380 seconds before it will be enabled again. Now, of course, if this timer expires and I receive another BPDU, the interface will go back into error disabled right away. So what you should do is then detach the router or disable spanning tree on the router, and then it can recover automatically and it should stay up again. So that's it. So this is how you can configure BPDU guard, and I also showed you how to configure the auto recovery. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, until next time.